championship match at Survivor Series. But the big question now is Paul Heyman wrong? Can Brock Lesnar beat the 7-foot, 500-pound Big Show?
We're going to find out less than 24 hours from the sold-out Madison Square Garden.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, weighing in at 268 pounds, Joe Colombo.
We are less than 24 hours away from Survivor Series, sold out at Madison Square Garden, Michael.
Yeah, we're kicking off a Survivor Series weekend, wetting your appetite with Velocity and then Confidential featuring Scott Steiner. More on that in the hour.
And what a great way to kick off Velocity here tonight. Chuck Palumbo taking on the Nut Crush.
Nut.
Yeah, look at him, Michael.
He's an idiot.
Well, he's crazy. He's just a strange superstar. I mean, bottom line.
Well, he enjoys performing, I'll tell you that.
There you go. That backs us up right there. He's already holding his back from jumping over ropes. He says the referee, Jimmy Corderas, just did. Pulled the ropes and made him fall. Look at him. He was looking at Corderas.
God, you must have ESP if you deciphered the fact that Crash said that.
Well,
or
look
was
at
thinking
him.
That.
He looked at Corderas and grabbed the rope and said, what are you doing?
He did?
Yeah, I'm begging you to open up your eyes and see what's going on.
I guess because I'm thinking of Survivor Series, less than 24 hours away on pay-per-view from the Garden tomorrow night.
Well, Michael, what's so intriguing about Survivor Series is, of course, all the great matches that will happen. 3 hours of nonstop action. But now between Brock Lesnar and The Big Show, is Paul Heyman wrong after what Brock Lesnar did to The Big Show this past week on SmackDown?
Well, it's a great question. I mean, the Brock Lesnar, with a vicious assault, all that pent-up frustration and anger finally coming out. This past Thursday night on SmackDown, as Brock Lesnar drove Big Show into the steel steps and busted him wide open with a bunch of steel chair shots to the head. I'll tell you, tomorrow night it's going to be interesting. Oh, look at this.
Bad news for Crash. Well, no, I guess not, but here comes Chuck. Chuck with some great strength, one of the top athletes here in the WWE, and a shot there to Crash his head. Oh,
that was forced by Chuck Palumbo. Chuck really making a name for himself one-on-one here. Of course, he's a former tag team champion with Billy Gunn. Billy out with an injury, and Chuck trying to carve his niche as a singles competitor.
And he's been doing just that. You're absolutely right, Michael. Chuck's been coming on strong, and no matter who he's been going up against.
Von Kraske.
He has the death claw or something.
What a fool.
What is he doing to the midsection? Chuck is laughing at Crash.
Oh, my.
Well, we talk about it. Crash is just insane. But now here he comes after Chuck Palumbo with some shots there to the midsection. A nice takedown there by Crash. And Michael, you said it. Wait, hang on here. Here comes Crash hooking outside leg, and Chuck kicks out of it. The look in Brock Lesnar's eyes was basically like, look, I am tired of being manhandled by The Big Show the past couple weeks. I've been thrown through a table. I've been thrown off the stage. I have a broken rib, but it doesn't matter because I'm the WWE champion, and I'm not going to take it anymore.
You're doing a great job this week of speaking for other people. I think Brock Lesnar's going to let his actions tomorrow night in the ring against The Big Show do the talking. He made a statement Thursday night, but now he's got to defend the title against The Big Show tomorrow night at Survivor Series. Now, you look at Crash Holly. He came to SmackDown from Raw to compete in the cruiserweight division. Well, Crash Holly is going to keep his eyes very closely on the cruiserweight title match tomorrow night at Survivor Series.
And that's a good point because Billy Kidman right now has defeated Jamie Noble 2 times in a row, the cruiserweight champion in non-title matches. Wait, hang on. Here's a cover. Chuck Palumbo gets out of it. Here's another cover now. Crash on a hook of the leg. And once again, Chuck's out of another hook of the leg.
It was 2 weeks ago that Billy Kidman defeated Jamie Noble with a shooting star press in a tag team matchup. This past week in a non-title match, Kidman defeated Noble again. Will the third time be a charm tomorrow night?
That's right. Billy Kidman goes for the hat trick tomorrow night. Survivor Series sold out Madison Square Garden in New York City. Check it out on pay-per-view. It's going to be an awesome event. So many great matches. And Crash really is kind of taking over this match right now. Using some nice tactics, trying to keep Chuck Palumbo on the ground so Chuck can't use that great size advantage he has when they're both upright.
Yeah, I thought it was perhaps the Iron Claw that actually got Crash back into this matchup.
And who is that, Baron? Who?
Baron Von Raschke. Baron Von Raschke was a former WWF star. Begging you to know your history.
There it comes. Oh. Now Chuck and a nice shot. That, oh, there goes Crash with a boot to the face of Chuck. And now Crash will attempt to climb to the top rope. Last time climbing over the ropes, he fell. And now Crash high above the ring. Oh, wow. What a mistake that was by Crash.
Well, great ring presence by Chuck Palumbo.
Oh,
you got to give Palumbo a hell of a lot of credit.
Oh, and another one.
Palumbo was reeling, and he took the advantage here.
As you say so often, maybe a desperation move there by Chuck Palumbo that keeps him alive. Now Chuck's in control, hooking the outside leg, and Crash kicks out.
Now Crash is the one who's desperate. Oh, ring of the eyes.
Here comes Crash. Oh, what a throw. There's that strength by Chuck Palumbo. And now look at him yelling at Crash. Oh, and there's a big discus punch.
Uh-oh.
Crash, jeez.
Crash landing.
Hook of the outside leg, three, and that's all she wrote for a Crash. And just like that, Chuck takes control of the match.
Here's
and picks
winner,
up the victory.
Chuck Palumbo.
Not Crash's move, but a real Crash landing at the hands of Chuck Palumbo there for the Cruiserweight Crash.
And Chuck Palumbo continues to roll here in the WWE. Still to come on Velocity, Cruiserweight champion Jamie Noble has been pinned by Billy Kidman 2 weeks in a row. Noble should be a little concerned about losing his Cruiserweight championship at Survivor Series. In fact, he has something to say right here tonight. Well, everybody, don't go anywhere right after Velocity.
Big because pump, pump!
You said it, Michael. Confidence will come
Paul,
up next.
If you hear me!
A huge story on Scott Steiner.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Boston, Mass. Weighing in at 350 pounds, Uber!
WWE Velocity is brought to you by Burger King. Now for a limited time, the new Extreme Bacon and Cheese Whopper at Burger King. At BK, you've got it.
And by Contract Shattered Soldier for PlayStation 2 and Game Boy Advance.
And by Truth, we've got knowledge. Pass it on. Infect Truth. Keep your fingers crossed that your boy Scott Steiner comes to SmackDown. Or I should say Taz's boy.
The truth about this is the fact that Albert Terry.
Well, there's no doubt about that. Here comes the high-flying Shannon Moore.
North Carolina weighing in at 195 pounds, Shannon Moore.
Well, Shannon Moore is outweighed by about 150 pounds in this match.
And obviously the strategy is going to be don't play into the strengths of Albert. That means, oh gosh, it's going to be tough not to play into the strengths of Albert. He's going to roll here on Velocity on the new TNN.
Shannon Moore, Cruiserweight, of course, Cruiserweight title on the line, Survivor Series, less than 24 hours away as Kidman and Noble lock up for the Cruiserweight title tomorrow night.
And also at Survivor Series, SmackDown GM Stephanie McMahon announced it this past week on Super Tuesday that a triple threat elimination match for the WWE Tag Team titles will be up for grabs. Michael, run down the participants in that great match.
The champions, of course, Edge and Rey Mysterio, the challengers Kurt Angle and Chris Benoit, and the Guerreros, Eddie and Chavo. Oh, wow. And I'll tell you, it's been Eddie Guerrero who has been on a major roll, which I think puts the Guerreros in the driver's seat come Sunday. You want to take a look? You want to take a look at this? It's simple. I believe the Guerreros are in the driver's seat. Eddie Guerrero's been on a major roll. Two big wins on Super Tuesday and SmackDown this past week.
Well, Michael, I know you're making a case for the team of the Guerreros, but after this past week on SmackDown, if Chris Benoit and Kurt Angle can be on the same page, then what a shot there by Shannon Moore. Albert Owen, another nice right hand and another one. Angle Benoit are on the same page. Then look out. I can't see them losing. That's how great those two superstars are.
Yeah, but you make a point of if they're on the same page. Angle admitted on SmackDown Thursday night that he hates Chris Benoit. He hates him. And can they get along for the entire length of the match on Sunday? And don't forget about Edge and Rey Mysterio. But the champions could be in a little bit of jeopardy. Rey Mysterio's got a bum knee. I'm not telling many people about it. And I'll tell you. Oh, look at this. The champions Edge and Rey Mysterio could be in trouble, but you can't doubt the heart of Mysterio and Edge.
Here comes Albert with the cover. Shannon Moore kicks out of it. And now look at Alvin. Just rubbing that huge forearm. Now choking Shannon.
Stop choking me. Get off.
Referee Brian Hebner
doing a good job telling Albert, you can't do that. Stop it. Albert just looks at Brian Hebner like, whatever. How about taking a headbutt from that head of Albert?
Hey, Albert, come down here. Lloyd wants to try a headbutt.
No, I never said that. Quiet. Cole, I'll tell you what, you're always trying to get me in trouble.
Oh!
And nobody wants any trouble from Albert.
Or Shannon Moore, for that matter. Oh, look at this.
Strength. Pure strength.
Oh!
The shoulder breaker. That'll dislocate the shoulder.
Now, Albert, really in complete control. Look at him smiling, waving his tongue around with that piercing there. Michael, Albert loves just
hurting people. Tell everybody what it's like to French kiss Albert with that ring in his tongue.
Let's not talk about French kissing, especially on SmackDown with you and Nitty a couple months ago. We won't even go there.
At least she's a woman, Mark.
Albert, a smart move there by Shannon Moore. And now Albert going into the steel post with the left shoulder.
Drop toe hold. Shannon Moore starting to use his ability and his quickness to gain control of the match.
Shannon Moore leaps off and lands right on Albert. That's a bicycle kick. Here comes Albert trying to set up the Bordeaux bomb. Oh, the impact.
Good night, Shannon.
That's right. 2, 3. Albert, the bully. One victory after the next. Remember, Michael, a while back, Albert was almost winning the matches when he couldn't close them out. But now Albert's doing just that, destroying everyone in his path.
Jamie Noble should be protective of his Cruiserweight title. He's been beaten by Billy Kidman 2 weeks in a row. In fact, Noble is furious and has something to say right here in the ring tonight on Velocity.
That's two in a row for Billy Kidman, Michael, over Jamie Noble heading into Survivor Series. But next time, the Cruiserweight title's on the line. Look at Nydia.
Hey, she just cut up a scuba suit.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Nydia and the WWE Cruiserweight champion, Jamie Noble.
Oh, you don't walk around hitting your woman on the ass?
No, not really. She's definitely not wearing jean shorts and a whatever you call it. She cut off a scuba suit.
You know, nonetheless,
they're proud of it, though. I mean, look at her. She's wanted. And Noble loves it.
We can sit here and joke about Jamie Noble all we want, but the bottom line is this. Jamie Noble is the Cruiserweight champion. Jamie Noble has held that title for 5 months since King of the Ring in June. Jamie Noble isn't planning on losing that title to Billy Kidman come Sunday. He and Nitty are going to do everything they can to keep that championship around Noble's waist.
Yeah, but you got to admit, the momentum is in favor of Billy Kidman right now.
Baby, wait, hang on. Take a look. And all these poor, pathetic people.
He's talking about you.
Not. He's talking about that guy.
For some reason, they ain't got no respect for me and you. But don't you worry your pretty little self about it. Because these people here, they're not our kind of people. A matter of fact, these people here in Ohio ain't nothing but plain old common trash. Look at us.
Master of the obvious.
No, we don't. Look at us. Look at me. I'm not trash. Look at this. I'm not trash. I'm a lady.
There you go.
And the tramp.
Yes, you are, girl. And you people need to start showing me and Nydia a little bit more respect. Because I'm Jamie Noble, Cruiserweight Champion.
And you know how long we've been Cruiserweight Champion? For a
gosh.
Long, long time.
That's right. Month after month, I've beaten every Cruiserweight that's had the nerve to step up and challenge Jamie Noble. And baby, this Sunday, Survivor Series, Jamie Noble versus Billy Kidman, Cruiserweight title. the result of that match is going to be the same as every other one. Jamie Noble goes in champion. Jamie Noble comes out champion. And you ain't going to be able to do nothing about it, Kidman. The only thing you're going to be able to do is respect the Cruiserweight champion, me, Jamie Noble.
Why is Jamie Noble yelling at me? Baby. You know what? Whether you like Noble or not, he is talking facts, though. I mean, whoever steps in the ring against him with the Cruiserweight titles on the line goes down in defeat.
You know, maybe Diddy could buy a calculator with a Survivor Series paycheck.
Well, Michael, we know just how much that Cruiserweight title means to Jamie Noble.
It means everything to them.
Exactly. Bottom line, right there, everything, the Cruiserweight title.
Maybe they can move up to a double wide.
Well, Michael, Jamie Noble needs to defeat Billy Kidman at Survivor Series if they're going to move up to that double wide. The Cruiserweight Championship is on the line at Survivor Series. Jamie Noble versus the challenger, Billy Kidman. Kidman's pinned Noble 2 weeks in a row. But can Noble prevent Kidman from being 3-for-3 while his goal's on the line?
Oh, testify!
Looks like another one bites the dust. Michael Rebecca calling in quits on Tough Enough 3.
Things are heating up. Can't wait for next week's episode.
Going for that WWE contract.
The following contest is scheduled for 1 fall. Approaching the ring, weighing in at 246 pounds, D-Von.
They should have toughened up for commentators. You would have never made it through the first week.
Oh, sorry, stud. Well, Xbox presents WWE Survivor Series live on pay-per-view from the sold-out Madison Square Garden. This holiday season, there's no power greater than X. Check it out at Xbox.com.
SmackDown commentator of all time.
Oh, that includes you too.
Well, yeah, but okay. At least I admit it.
What am I? I'm in denial?
I'm not insecure.
Oh, there's a good word. Here comes D-Von and Funaki. Should be a... Really, it's an unbalanced match, but as we saw Shannon Moore against Albert, yeah, Albert got the victory, but Shannon Moore trying to use that quickness. We'll see if Funaki does the same against a stronger D-Von here.
24 hours away, cannot wait. Oh. Sold out Madison Square Garden tomorrow night. Survivor Series.
And Michael, I need to ask you this question too. What's up with Paul Heyman talking to the Big Show? I mean, is Paul Heyman jockeying for position just in case Brock Lesnar loses to be on the Big Show's good side? Explain that to everybody.
Well, you know, Paul Heyman's a scumbag. We all know that. I have no doubt about it. I mean, the guy's a slime ball. And maybe he is jockeying for position to put himself in line with perhaps the new champion. But I believe what Paul Heyman was doing was, number one, trying indeed to protect his client, Brock Lesnar, who does have a broken rib. And number two, Paul Heyman has been very negative toward Brock Lesnar, perhaps trying to fire up the champion.
There comes Funaki. Clive getting the crowd going. Nice shot there to the head of D-Von. Funaki with some takedowns is taking a little bit of control of this match here against D-Von, using the quickness that we talked about.
To get back to Brock Lesnar for a moment, he is the youngest champion in WWE history. And he has made some young mistakes in recent months. I mean, Brock Lesnar got himself into Hell in a Cell matchup. It's the Undertaker. Brock Lesnar got himself into this predicament with the Big Show. Not because he's stupid, but because he's a competitive champion. Brock Lesnar needs to be competitive. It's what drives him as a man. But the problem is he needs to keep that competitiveness in check or he's going to get himself hurt.
Well, Michael, you talked about some of the mistakes maybe Brock Lesnar's made. Is one of them really not having a chance to recover? Hang on, here's a cover there by D-Von, and Funaki kicks out, not having a chance to recover from whatever injuries he sustained in that Hell in a Cell match against The Undertaker.
Well, not only did he sustain injuries that nobody knows about in Hell in a Cell, because as Paul Heyman said, his champion refused medical attention after the match, but we do know for a fact that Brock Lesnar has a broken rib.
rehab after Big Show tossed him from the stage 2 weeks ago. A broken rib that has had Brock Lesnar coughing up blood for a week. And we saw that the way the ribs were taped on SmackDown Thursday night. The champion is going into the Garden tomorrow for Survivor Series, less than 100% mark against a guy who's 7 feet tall, 500 pounds, and who's been reborn, and that's the Big Show.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And how difficult is that going to be for Brock Lesnar? Obviously, going against the Big Show, you need to be at 100%. You need to have all your strength. And now, though, any strength moves that Brock Lesnar uses, will that damage his rib throughout the match?
You know, and it's not even against the Big Show. In the WWE today.
D-Von kicks out.
And especially if you're the champion and everybody's gunning for you, you have to be 100% every night of the week. It doesn't matter who you're going against. But the fact you're going against the Big Show, well, that's even worse.
Hook an outside leg. Funaki gets the left shoulder up. And Michael, you just saw the quickness and also the strength of D-Von just then. Wham, one, two, and wham. Had Funaki on his back and go for the cover. There comes D-Von climbing the ropes. Rolls out of the way. D-Von's head goes right into the canvas there.
Well, look at D-Von. He still has the wherewithal to grab the leg of Funaki to try to keep him grounded on the mat. That's the experience of D-Von.
Also, at Survivor Series, a nice shot there by Funaki to the head of D-Von. The triple threat elimination match. Tag team titles on the line. The champions, Rey Mysterio and Edge, up against the teams of Chris Benoit.
Oh,
and also Eddie and Chavo Guerrero.
Look out! Wait,
hang on. Here's a hook in the leg. D-Von gets the right shoulder up.
Keep in mind, Funaki actually pinned D-Von last week in a tag team matchup right here on Velocity.
Well, Michael, it's one thing to beat D-Von in a tag team match, but it's something else to defeat him in singles competition. It would be a huge upset.
Well, Funaki
maybe
made the right here.
You're absolutely right. Hook in the leg, and D-Von gets out of it. How about
so
what kind of confidence would that give Funaki to knock off a superstar like D-Von?
Give him huge confidence, but guess what?
Uh-oh.
I think Funaki's run's over.
Oh, jeez. Just like that, hook it away. Lights out. Keeping our fingers crossed that Scotty Steiner signs to SmackDown.
Yeah, maybe we'll see him on Velocity in the next couple of weeks.
Well, Survivor Series coming up live tomorrow night, pay-per-view. Confidential, though, is right now. And the truth I see, yes, I